Hello friends, welcome to my lecture on various types of graphs. Let us first see why we need a graph theory. Many situations that occur in computer science, physical science, communication science, economics and many other areas can be analyzed by using techniques found in a relatively new area of mathematics called graph theory. The graph can be used to represent almost any problem involving discrete arrangements of objects, where concern is not with the internal properties of these objects, but with relationship among them. We begin with basic graph terminology and then we will discuss some important concepts in graph theory with many applications of graphs. Now, let us first define what we mean by a graph. A graph consists of two parts, B equal to BG, okay, whose elements are called vertices. Points are nodes. Okay. A graph is G. A graph G consists of two parts, a set B equal to BG, whose elements are called vertices, points are nodes, a collection E equal to EG of unordered pairs of vertices called edges. We write GVE when we want to emphasize the two parts of G. Let us consider the graph shown in this figure. Okay. Here you can see that there are four vertices in this graph, okay. A, B, C and D, okay. And A, B, C, D are joined by means of the edges E1 is AB, E4 that is AC, E2 that is BC, E3 that is CD and BD that is A5. Okay. So, there are four vertices A, B, C, D and E. Okay. E is the set of edges, E consists of five edges E1, E2, E3, E4, E5. So, this is a graph. Now, let us see what is a simple graph. A graph that has neither self loops nor parallel edges, okay, are called a simple graph. So, this graph is a simple graph. This graph is a simple graph because it does not contain parallel edges. Okay. Now, are self loops. What are simple parallel edges and simple parallel edges and loops? Let us see. We first define multigraph. In a multigraph, each vertex B is represented by a dot or a small circle, and each edge E equal to UB is represented by a curve which connects end points U and B. A graph is generally shown by drawing its diagram rather than by listing its vertices and edges. We have talked about parallel edges. What are parallel edges? All edges having the same pair of end vertices are called parallel edges. And self loop is an edge having the same vertices is called a self loop. Let us look at this figure. In this, this is a multigraph. You can see here there are four vertices A, B, C and D, okay. And the edges are E1, okay, E1 which is AB, then we have E2 is BC and then E3 is CD. E4 is AC E5 is AC again E6 BD E7 is DD. So, you can see that this edge E7 has same end vertices, okay, DD, same end vertices. So, this is a self loop. And E4 and E5 edges have the same end vertices AC, okay. E4 and E5 have the same end vertices. So, E4 and E5 are parallel edges. So, this graph consists of parallel edges E4 and E5 and a self loop E7. Okay. Now, let us go to this diagram. Okay. Here again we see that there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 vertices. Okay. Vertices are P1, P2, P3, P4, P5. Okay. And the set of edges is E equal to P1, 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 P1 is a, because P1, P1 means it has the same end vertices. Okay. So, same vertices here. So, this is a self loop. So, this is a self loop. Because this edge has same end vertices P1 P1. Okay. Now we have P2 P3. Okay. P2 P3, and we have P3 P2. Okay. Since here again the end vertices are same, these are parallel edges. Okay. So P2 P3 and P3 P2 are parallel edges. Okay, and we have P2 P4, we have P4 P1. Okay, P4 P1 here, P5 P4. Okay, so this is a multigraph which consists of one self loop and two parallel edges. A multigraph is said to be finite if both the set of vertices is finite and the set of edges is finite. Now let us note that if there are only finite number of vertices in the graph, then it must always be having a finite number of edges, because when the vertices are finite, when you join them, you will have only finite number of edges. So, the graph must be finite. So, the multigraph will be called finite if number of vertices are actually finite. Now, trivial graph. A trivial graph is the graph with one vertex, okay, and no edges. So, in the case of a trivial graph, there is one vertex, no edges. The empty graph is the graph with no vertices and no edges. Okay. Isolated vertex, a vertex having no edge incident on it is called an isolated vertex. Let us look at this figure, okay, this graph. So, you see here we have 5 vertices, okay, P1, P2, P3, P4, P5, okay, 5 vertices are there, edges are P2, P4, okay, P2, P3, P2, P3, P3, P5, P3, P5, P5, P4, and this P1, it has no edges incident on it. So, this P1 is an isolated vertex, because though there are no edges incident on it, so it is an isolated vertex. Now, let g equal to g b have 5 vertices. Okay. Let g equal to g b have 5 vertices. Find the maximum number m of the edges in E if g is a graph. Okay. To draw an edge, you have to connect 2 vertices. Okay. So, 5c2, number of edges, if you take any 2 vertices. Okay. If you take any 2 vertices, then you have number of edges will be 5c2. In a graph means a simple graph here. Okay, we are by graph here we mean simple graph. Where there are no loops and no parallel edges. Okay, so you take any 2 vertices to draw an edge. Okay, we will have number of edges 5c2. 5c2 means 10. So, when no self loops and no parallel edges are there and we have 5 vertices, number of maximum number of edges could be 5c2, okay, that is 10. Now, g is a multigraph. If g is a multigraph, then you can have any number of parallel edges, any number of self loops. Okay. So, there is no maximum number of edges in E, okay, in the case of a multigraph. Now, suppose E equal to UB is an edge in a graph G, okay, then U and B are end points of E, The vertex U is called adjacent to the vertex B, and the edge E is said to be incident on U and B on B. Okay, so if you take U and B two points, okay, the two vertices, and this is an edge, okay, then U and B are called adjacent to each other, and E is said to be incident on U and B. Degree of a vertex, okay, that the degree of a vertex could be either even or odd. And the what, how we define the degree? The degree of a vertex B in a graph written as degree V is equal to the number of edges which are incident on B, or in other words, the number of edges which contain B as an endpoint. The vertex B is said to be even or odd according as the degree of B is even or odd. Okay. Now let's see. We will consider this theorem first. The sum of degrees of the vertices of a graph is equal to the twice the number of edges. This is because each edge is counted twice, okay, in counting the degree of the vertices of a graph G. So suppose you have a graph G and we have two vertices, okay, U and B. This is the edge, okay. Then while counting the degree of U, okay, this vertex, this edge will be counted. While counting the degree of B, this edge again will be counted. So since each edge is counted twice in counting the degree of the vertices of a graph G, therefore the sum of degrees of the vertices of a graph is equal to twice the number of edges. Now let's consider this graph, okay. This graph G equal to GVE in this figure. Describe G formally. So in order to describe G, we need to know how many vertices are there and how many edges are there. So B equal to BG. This denotes the vertices. Okay, vertices are A, B, C, D, E. These are the vertices, and then we have E equal to EG. Okay. So we have now let us list the edges of this multigraph. Okay, so we have AB. Okay, this is AB. Then we have BC. Okay, we have taken this. We have taken this. Then we have AC. So we have considered this one. And then we have BE, then we have EC, and then we have CD, we also have AD, okay. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And 7, okay, 7 edges are there. Okay, now degree of each vertex we have to find. Okay, so degree of A, let us see. Degree of A. Now you see how many edges are incident on A. So one, that is AB, then AC, and then AD. 3 edges are incident on A. So degree of A equal to 3. Degree of B. We have this edge BA, then we or you can say AB, and then we have EB, and we have CB. Okay, so 3 edges are incident on B, and then we have degree of C. So we have AC incident on C, BC, and we have EC. Okay, and we have DC also. So we have 4, and then we have degree of let us say D. Okay. So, we have CD incident on D, we have AD incident on D, so degree of D is 2. Okay. This one and this one, now they are incident on D, and then we have degree of E. So, how many edges are incident on E? BE and CE. Okay. So, we have 2. And the sum of degrees of the vertices of this multigraph are 3 plus 3, 4, 6, 6 plus 4, 10, 10, 12, 14. So, sum of degrees. is equal to 14 and the edges are 7, okay. Number of edges are, so you can see this is twice the number of edges. So, this verifies the theorem which we have just now seen, the sum of the degrees of the vertices of a graph is equal to twice the number of edges. Now, let us consider the graph G where B G equal to A B C D. So, in this graph there are 4 vertices A, B, C and we have D, okay. E G, now this is the set of edges. So, we have edges are A B and we have B C, we have B D and we have C D, okay. So, let us find the degree. So, this is a multi graph, okay, and we have the degree and parity degree of each vertex, degree of A, there is only one edge incident on A. So, we have 1, degree of B equal to 1, 2, 3, 3 edges are incident on B. So, we have 3, degree of C, there are 2 edges incident on C. So, we have 2 and degree of D, there are 1, 2, 2 edges incident on D. So, we have. So, total of the sum of degrees equal to, four plus two plus two, that is 8, okay, and edges are 1, 2, 3, 4, okay, and number of edges are 4, okay. So, sum of degrees of the vertices of G is equal to twice the number of edges of G, okay. So, that verifies the theorem we have stated. Thank you very much for your attention.